I hope that you have had a lot of fun. Wait. Yeah. I hope that you have had a lot of fun. I hope that you have enjoyed the classes so far. I hope that you are working alone so you can send everything when you request it to. Today we are going to continue reading Already Player One. Remember that yesterday we read we started reading chapter chapter 5. We were talking about Wade and how he was studying specific class to research Halliday's life, and today we are going to continue doing it. We are going to read page, according to what I have in here, 59, 60, and 61. But before we say which pages, let's start with the date. So we are going to write in here, today is Tuesday, January 19th, 2021. Okay, and then the topic will be Ready Player One pages, and then let me tell you the pages. So we read until 58 yesterday, so now we are going to read 59. 59. Remember that you have to take notes on important facts. Ready Player One. Yep, I have it in here. Give me a sec. So pages 59 on. So let's start reading it. Remember that we have said multiple times that it's very important that you take your own important facts, we discuss them, and then you copy them, because that's going to be part of your cumulative, but also part of what you are going to study for your exams, okay? Have on hand your pen. I have a pink one because I don't have any other one, and I don't want to leave my house because of COVID. So copy your important facts with a pen in cursive in there, and remember to always write the reference page so you know what are we talking about. Today I will give you a couple ones that I'm gonna make myself, and then you're gonna do one or two pages by yourself. Okay, remember to do them because you never do well. Most of you never do them. Thank you for all the 6 girls that always do it. You're learning a lot. But try to remember all the other people that you have to do it, because that also comes in your exam, okay? So let's go to page 59. Give me a second. 59. Okay. So yeah, we made it until 50. What? Okay, 58. Let's do 59. We set the date, right? Yeah, we said Tuesday, January 19th in here. Okay. Halliday created Anorak's quest for fun. To share with the guys in his D&D, remember Dungeons & Dragons, just like in Stranger Things, gaming group. They all found the game addictive and lost countless hours attempting to solve its hinting crate riddles and puzzles. Ogden Morrow convinced Halliday that Anorak's quest was better than most of the computer games currently on the market, and encouraged him to try selling it. He helped Halliday create some simple cover artwork for the game, and together the two of them had hand-copied Anorak's quest into dozens of 5 1/4-inch floppy disks, and stuck them into Ziploc bags along with a single photocopied sheet of instructions. They began selling the game on the software rack at their local computer store. Before long, they couldn't make copies fast enough to meet the demand. So, Halliday and Ogden Morrow, they were friends, and they invented a game that was sold very quickly. Dungeons & Dragons, it's, maybe I can find a video. Let me write it here. Video on Dungeons & Dragons. Okay? That I can show you what Dungeons & Dragons looks like, okay? Morrow and Halliday, Halliday and Morrow almost didn't graduate from high school because they spent most of their senior year working on Anorak's Quest 2. And instead of going off to college, they both focused all their energy on their new company, which had now grown too large for Morrow's basement. In 1990, Gregarious Games moved into its first real office. So they called the company Gregarious Games, located in a rundown strip mall in Columbus, Ohio. I know that place. That's where my friend lives in Ohio, but she makes me fly from Atlanta to Columbus. Over the next decade, the small company took the video game industry by storm, releasing a series of best-selling action and adventure games, all using a groundbreaking first-person graphics engine created by Halliday. Gregarious Games set a set of standards for immersive gaming, and every time they released a new title, it pushed the envelope of what seemed possible on the computer hardware available at the time. The rotten Ogden Morrow was naturally charismatic, and he handled all of the company's business, affairs, and public relations. At every gregarious, unruly, varied, and wide-rimmed spectacles, I'm going to read the last paragraph again, because I'm not wearing my glasses, so I skipped a line. The rotund Ogden Morrow was naturally charismatic. I think rotund means that he was kind of chubby. And he handled all of the company's business affairs and public relations. At every gregarious game press conference, Morrow grinned infectiously from behind his unruly beard and wide-rimmed spectacles. Using his natural gift for hype and hyperbole, Halliday seemed to be Morrow's polar opposite. In every way, he was tall, gaunt, and painfully shy, as he preferred to stay out of the limelight. People employed by Gregarious Game during this period said that Halliday frequently locked himself in his office, where he programmed incessantly, often going without food, sleep, or human contact for days or even weeks. Okay, so what would be from page 58, from page 59, what would be my important fact? Ogden Morrow and James Halliday created Gregarious Games. You can see how it's written in the book. Period. Yeah, Gregarious Games, yes. And their games were very popular. James was shy and Ogden was social. Okay? That's like a basic idea of what the chapter is. So far your notebook should look kind of like this. Okay? With the summary of what we're writing. Let's continue. Page 60. So we're gonna write in here from page 60. On the few occasions that Halliday agreed to do interviews, his behavior came off as bizarre, even by game designer standards. He was hyperkinetic, aloof, and socially inept that the interviewers often came away with the impression that he was mentally ill. So he was so distracted, he was so into his own mind, that people thought that he was a retard. And he was a genius, but he was very social, so people thought that he was a retard. Halliday tended to speak so rapidly that his words were often unintelligible, and he had a disturbing high-pitched laugh, made even more so because he was usually the only one who knew what he was laughing about. So he was a weirdo. He was into talking, he was always shy, and he was telling jokes that he was the only one that understood. When Halliday got bored during an interview or conversation, he would usually get up and walk out without saying a word. Wow, he's serious. Halliday had many well-known obsessions. Chief among them were classic video games, sci-fi and fantasy novels, and movies of all genres. He also had an extreme fixation in the 1980s, the decade during which he'd been a teenager. Halliday seemed to expect everyone around him to share his obsession, and he often lashed out at those who didn't. He was known to fire longtime employees for not recognizing an obscure line of movie dialogue he quoted, or if he discovered they weren't familiar with one of his favorite cartoons, comic books, or video games. Of the moral will always hire the employees back, usually without Halliday ever noticing. So, I'm sorry, my neighbor said about the word, I guess. Halliday was someone that was very antisocial, and actually not only that, but he would fire people for not knowing information that was required for their work. Yes, but I mean, if you hire to make video games and you don't know something about the 80s, might as well you can just make a research. But he was very erratic and angry. As the years went on, Halliday already stunted social skills will seem to deteriorate even farther. Several exhaustive psychological studies were done on Halliday's following his death, and his obsessive adherence to routine and preoccupation with a few obscure areas of interest led many psychologists to conclude that Halliday had suffered from Asperger's syndrome or from some other form of high-functioning autism. That's what Aiden has. He has Asperger's. That's a disease in which you're not very social. Doesn't mean you're retard, you're just not very social. Despite his I'm thinking that saying retard is kind of mean. I'm gonna withhold from that. I'm sorry that I said it. I would say, because my Spanish teacher from university taught me better, I'm sorry that I said it like that. I apologize. I think that the best term for that would be special needs students. So people thought that he was a special needs student because he had Asperger's. I'm sorry that I said it that way. I'm pretty sure the people doesn't approve, and I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get a lot of backlash from saying that word. So I apologize. Because my brother has it, and I should be more empathetic to it. I'm sorry. Despite his eccentricities, no one ever questioned Halliday's genius. The games he created were addictive and widely popular. By the end of the 20th century, Halliday was widely recognized as the greatest video game designer of his generation, and some would argue of all time. Ogden Morrow was a brilliant programmer in his own right, but his true talent was his knack for business. In addition to collaborating on the company's games, he masterminded all of their early marketing campaigns and shareware distribution, schemes with outstanding results. When Gregarious Games finally went public, their stock immediately shot into the stratosphere. By their 30th birthdays, Halliday and Morrow were both multimillionaires. Okay, so let's stop there for a second. For page 60, we can write in there. So I gave you 59, so you have to write 60 by yourself. So you have to write in there the description of Halliday's personality. He probably had Asperger's, which made him a special needs student. He was very antisocial. He didn't like talking. He didn't like interviews or questions. And he was very quick to get angry because of the special personality that he had. And most of the time, he was locked in his office making games. And Ogden Morrow was the face of the company. He was the one talking to people. And by 30 years old, 2 years younger than me, they were multimillionaires. That should be amazing. Then, copy your own. I mean, I gave you my ideas. If you want to stop the video and copy, that's okay. And then, 61 from page 61 is going to be done by you, okay? So you are going to read 61 in order to finish. So you can do 61 too. So I'm going to write it in here. Okay, let me see. So I have 61 alone, okay? Okay? So I hope that you are enjoying this. Don't forget that I'm going to post a video related to Dungeons & Dragons so you can see what Dungeons & Dragons are. I apologize for the word that I said that is incorrectly used. I'm sorry that I used such a term. I'm not gonna cry. Because it's related to my brother. So I'm sorry that I was such a insensitive person, the correct form for someone that has Asperger's or any other disability would be special needs student or special needs person. I'm sorry that I was such a mean person. I hope that you apologize me, and that will be it for today. I hope that you're okay. I hope that you're having fun, and until tomorrow. Bye, guys.